There are so many different project management tools available to you and I, and you may have your favorites and I may have mine, or you may be using a combination of project management tools as a part of your day-to-day. Well, wouldn't it be great if you could get the best out of all of these tools and have them communicate with one another? Well, you can, and you can do it with Unito. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to connect some of the most popular project management tools, including Asana, Trello, Monday.com, Jira, GitHub, and many, many more, including showing you Unito's brand new workflow interface. So let's dive in. Let's say that Asana happens to be my favorite tool for managing my personal to-do list. Perhaps it's something that I've used for a number of years, and I like managing all of my tasks and all of my personal projects here within Asana. But what if my team uses Trello and we're working together on a team project, and they're going to be assigning certain things to me, and there's going to be certain conversations happening here in Trello regarding my work and things that are going to be assigned to me as tasks, but I'd like to spend most of my day still here within Asana. Well, the great thing about Unito is that it allows us to create connections so that we can sync information between different products or even between the same products. So let's get back to our example. So here is where I like to spend most of my day. I want to prioritize and manage my own tasks here, and I would love it if things that were assigned to me on this team Trello board would show up here within Asana. So already you can see that I have this connection working. You can see that there are two things here at the top of the list, a great idea and an easy task to start out with, and those are actually coming here from the Trello board. Why? Because I've set up a flow within Unito, whereas whenever anything is assigned to me here in Trello, it's going to show up on my Asana board. Let's take a look at an example. So let's say this one here, research new way of doing business in 2021. And someone comes into Trello, maybe it's my boss or my manager, and they say, you know what, I'd like Scott to take that on. So they're going to come in here and they're going to assign me to this task. And on top of that, maybe they want to do a few other things. Maybe they're going to push out this due date. They're going to push it out a week to November 6th, for example. And they're also going to write a comment and say, Scott, can you please give me an update later this week? All right, so they've included a message. They're doing a number of things here that you may think is only Trello specific. However, let's jump over to Asana and see what happens. Now when I click on my Asana tab here at the top of my personal list, remember, not all of these things are coming from Trello. Here at the very top is this research new way of doing business in 2021, and it's got the due date that was created in Trello. If I open up the details, I can even see the comments down here as well. Scott, can you please give me an update later this week? So not only is the title of the Trello card matched and synced over, but things such as the due date, description, if there was a description, I didn't add one in this particular example, comments are all coming over. So I don't need to jump back and forth between these tabs or between these tools. I can continue my productive workday working here within Asana, and whenever something is either updated, changed, or assigned to me specifically, it will show up here within my Asana tab. Now remember, it works both ways. So let's take a look at this one here, for example, an easy task to start out with. You'll notice that it doesn't have a due date. And if we come over here, you can see in Trello, of course, the same thing is going to apply here. But this time, I want to update it in Asana. So I'm going to click on the details. And I'm going to say, let's apply a due date to next week. How about, let's do it over there. And let's maybe add a description here. I'm just going to say, add a description next time. Come on, let's make sure we know what we're doing here. Okay, so we've got the description. We've added a due date. Is it going to show up on the other side? Let's see. If I click on my Trello tab, here is that same task. You can see already that that new date, October 29th, has been added. And here is my description, which I entered over on Asana. So a perfect two-way sync. I can continue to spend my day-to-day where I like to be, and my team or my project manager can spend their time here within Trello managing the rest of the project. Now, this is a relatively simple example, but let's go under the covers to see how this works. Here you can see I'm managing a number of different flows within Unito. And at the bottom here, I have my Unito to Trello example. If I come over here and say edit, we can take a look at some of the different rules and things that are set up. So for example, under rules, you can see here that I am only filtering cards that are assigned to me, right? Those are the only things that I want to send over to the Asana side. I don't want to see the entire board. However, that's another good use case for Unito. If you want to mirror an entire project in another application, you can do so as well. But the other powerful feature here within Unito is if we go over to field mappings, you can see how everything is mapped together. That's exactly why the titles are the same, the descriptions are the same, for example, comments, due dates, etc. And you can also choose if you want the flow to go just in one direction. Perhaps you don't want the dual sync depending on your particular use case scenario. But let's also take a look under the covers at the new workflow section here within Unito, because this makes building your flows so much easier. If I open up the edit window, here you can see the existing example that I just showed you. I have my team project board here within Trello connected to my Asana to-do list. And if I click on this little check mark, you can see that the connection is healthy, it's happening, and I can open this up and start to edit the things that we just saw in the previous screen. But we can go so much further than just connecting two different work areas or two different projects. So for example, if I come over here, I can add a new block. I'm going to select one of my already connected accounts. In this case, I'm going to select Trello, and I'm going to select this test board here and say add block. So now you see I have another Trello component, and I can choose as to where I would like to connect it. So in this case, let's say that there's an item here within this team project area which really deserves its own board. It almost needs a collection of subtasks. So that's why I've created an additional Trello board. I'm going to filter some of the information from this existing team project board, and I'm going to come over here, and maybe it's just myself and two other individuals who are going to work at this level. All I need to do is click on one of these plus areas here and drag it to the component that I'd like to connect it to, and now I've got another connection made here. Now, first I'm gonna have to hit this plus button to actually figure out the details as to what I want to create over. You'll be familiar with this screen because we just looked at some of the rules and we just looked at some of the field mappings here as well. But once we've made our proper selections, if we come back to our workflow area, we will see a check mark just like the one we see here when everything is flowing properly. So you can make connections either within the same project management tool or between a variety of some of your most popular project management tools. Well, I hope you found this video helpful. And if you'd like to try out Unito for yourself, be sure to click the link in the description below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.